Good morning to the Dogecoin community. Welcome to another Daily Dose of Doge, Shadow Realm Edition. And we had a very nice move yesterday. So we were making the case that October would be a good month. Depends on how you look at it. By definition, for Bitcoin, October was a good month. For Dogecoin, October was a very good month. But for Ethereum, which is what I was looking for, it was just not a good month. It was not a good guess. I really thought we would have a nice breakout in October, and we didn't get it. Now, I'm not sitting here being all poo-poo. I mean, you can clearly see Bitcoin is potentially pulling away. I have a lot of Hopium to distribute, as you all know, if you're new to the channel. And if you don't, well, I guess if you're new to the channel, you don't know. But I try my best to only distribute medically graded and FDA-approved hopium. I try not to make it out of thin air. Doesn't mean it's always right, but I try not to say Bitcoin to 300K. But I do have some medically regulated hopium. So this is not medical advice by any means, not financial advice as well. It is all satire. But I do want to highlight that, as we've been mentioning, which I'm sure everyone is saying at this point, right? It's really no mystery that the Bitcoin dominance has been climbing. But if you measure it historically, about 230 days post-halving seems to be when it starts falling. It happened in 2017. It happened again in 2020. I would imagine that it's going to happen again this time around. Now, it doesn't have to be exactly 230 days, but just for the record, 230 days is still pretty far away, right? That's all the way out in December. So maybe it happens before that. Maybe it happens after that. With all of the predictions that I've been making, I'm not going to pinpoint the exact day, but the whole idea is generally it's exciting that we're getting closer to that time. Right, but that's not the hopium that I'm trying to show you. The medically regulated hopium that I'm trying to show you is in 2020, the Bitcoin dominance was rallying all through the fall, and everything was kind of in the gutter. Now, there's a slight difference, right? Obviously, last cycle, Ethereum was rallying in October, whereas right now, we don't have that. But the good news is, if you do compare to last cycle, referring to Dogecoin, you can actually see that in that time period, as I just showed you, the Bitcoin dominance rallied from September to January. Dogecoin actually also rallied from as the Bitcoin dominance was rallying. And we're actually seeing that right now, which is a very, very good sign. Okay, this is a beautiful sign for Dogecoin. Now, I would even take it a step further and say, well, medically regulated hopium, I don't want to delete this chart because we always say we're going to keep it, but look at exactly what's happening. From the top to the bottom, you came up to the 236 and fell in the fall, and you started rallying back up to the 236 as the Bitcoin dominance rallied. We are doing that exact same thing right now, where from the high down to the low, we hit the 236, we fell in the fall, and now we're starting to rally up to the 236, which, again, this was heading into December, now we're heading into November, so could we have shifted over a month? Of course, right? Again, as I said earlier with the Bitcoin dominance, I'm not going to make some bogus prediction just to be wrong or right. I said October would be bullish. Unfortunately, the Ethereum prediction was wrong. And we'll leave it at that. I'm not going to keep moving the goalpost. But that doesn't mean I don't want to show you what's happening, because it's pretty obvious that it's potentially replicating the previous market cycle. So we don't want to expect the same exact thing to happen again. But if we use it as a guide, considering that Ethereum is actually dead right now versus last cycle, Ethereum was rallying with the Bitcoin dominance. It wasn't that much, but it was going up. We are dead. Ethereum is dead right now. But the fact that Dogecoin is pushing up with the Bitcoin dominance may, again, we don't want to turn too much into moon boys and moon girls, but we made the case a couple of days ago that yes, the market cycles are getting weaker, because there's more coins, and Ethereum is clearly performing weaker every time. However, we could also make the case, think of it like this. Let's say there's 100 car brands, right? Everybody knows Toyota, Ford, Tesla, Jeep, right? But Hondas and Toyotas are known to be reliable. So in a world where there's hundreds of car brands, people still buy Toyota because they know it's reliable. We could see something like that with Dogecoin, where maybe Dogecoin is your Toyota. And even though the market cap is 20 to 30 billion, and there's 2.4 million other coins that have less market caps, they might not have the Toyota reliability. So people may still just pile into Dogecoin, even though there's other options. I'm not saying that has to happen, but it appears it may, because it's starting to climb. And I cannot stress this enough. Yes, there are other meme coins that will outperform Dogecoin, but they're not moving, and they're not going to move until Ethereum moves. And that is because that's what's going to make the Bitcoin dominance fall. But because of the fact that Doge is moving up without Ethereum, it could potentially set us up for the Toyota theory, where, it's a Honda Civic. You know, the used car, the Solana used car with a Honda. You know, it might not be that crazy to expect. So what I would say is, everything that we've been saying, we should still be looking for. Unfortunately, it wasn't in October, but listen, when this Dogecoin pops through this 22 cents, it should go right to 30 and then 39 and then 47. And I would make the case that as it starts climbing higher, the conservative estimate, in my opinion, would be 92 to 157. But if Ethereum didn't even, here, let me put it this way. If Ethereum didn't make a new all-time high, this is like getting off the medical hopium. This is kind of like hopium now. But if Ethereum isn't at a new all-time high and Dogecoin is back at the high, you could set up for a 2+ Dogecoin. Now, I still think a conservative estimate would be 92 to 115. But listen, if the Toyota Honda Civic analogy comes true and everybody's piling in because they don't know what to buy, it's very possible it does go to $2, all right? Now, the best way to gauge how high it'll potentially end up going is, yes, obviously, you could look at the USD price. But as we've mentioned a couple of videos ago, we want to continue to monitor the Bitcoin pair, because the Bitcoin pair will ultimately determine how high the price ends up going in USD value. So we could see that the Bitcoin pair did actually curl up. However, you did not break this big downtrend yet, so it's not yet time to start screaming Bitcoin dominance down, Doge to the moon. But I would argue once it breaks this downtrend, it is going to be very bullish for Dogecoin. Now, uncoincidentally, I would imagine that 22 cent range that's holding us down is probably going to be when we're up here. And then that'll finally be Dogecoin breaking a 3-year downtrend. And if it breaks this downtrend, you can see right now Doge is at 16 cents. If it goes all the way up here, right, that's a 343% gain, which from right now would put us all the way up at 80 cents. Now, obviously, if Dogecoin or the Bitcoin pair rather goes higher than that, you know, then you could be looking for a much higher price. So we don't want to overdose on hopium just yet, but I would make the argument that the Bitcoin dominance is nearing its top, which I'm sure everyone is saying that. And I would really start really paying attention to how high Dogecoin gets, because if Dogecoin starts peeking through or hitting this 22 cents, the earlier it does that, I'll end the video with this medical hopium. In my opinion, the faster Dogecoin breaks through 22 cents, the more likely it is to go higher than expected. Okay, because usually alt season lasts from a sample size of 2, 4 to 8 months. And if Dogecoin is able to break through 22 cents without even having alt season, then that tells me the Toyota theory is true and people are going to pile into Dogecoin, and it very well may go to $2. But we want to wait and see, obviously, what happens at that 23, 22 cent mark. So that is pretty much it. As always, none of this is financial advice.